In your time playing Counter-Strike, you've probably seen your fair share of round-changing Deagle half-buys, but I'll let you in on a little secret. There's actually a lot of strategy into winning them. What's up, ProGuides family? My name is Nathan Ng, and today we'll be discussing half-buys and how you can start winning those rounds. So hit that sub button, and let's just jump right into it.
All right, the first thing that you have to know about winning half-buys is that there's not just one solution to the problem, there's lots of roads that lead to Rome. And it's not just the question of which way is the best way either. Certain methods work a lot better in certain ranks, and some definitely take a lot more individual skill than others. So let's just jump right into it. The first method, which is probably the best one in the lower ranks, is just blindly stacking bomb sites. Rushes are very, very common to see in the lower ranks, and oftentimes people don't notice a bomb site is stacked until it's ready too late. If you're in the lower ranks, this is by far the best strategy to call on the CT side of your ecos and half buys. The thing about doing these gamble stacks though is that you have to do it properly, and it's really easy to mess up. In order to get a proper stack, you can't just have 5 people peeking all angles at once. If you want to do that, you'll probably just get 1 or 2 kills, but it's very unlikely that you'll win the round. Of course, if a kill or 2 is what you're looking for, set up on one of those Australis pyramid stacks all you want. But if you want to win the round, you're gonna have to approach it another way. There's actually 2 things that you can do. You could either let the usual defenders fight while the rest of the team hides. So if you're stacking B site, let the B defenders play the usual while the rest of the team hides somewhere around corners. That way, if anybody attacks the site and kills the usual B defenders but fails to spot anybody else, they may not suspect that there's a stack going on. Which usually means that this person and his team will continue to look for the bomb site unsuspecting and hopefully with the bomb, allowing for easy frags and control of the most important objective in the game. Or number 2, you could do your gamble stack a different way and have the entire team hiding. Your goal here is to bait your opponents into rushing you and go in too far. Or alternatively, that they just contact in and again go too deep. From my personal experience, it can be a little bit difficult to get the whole team to not peek though. So if 4 of your enemies are peeking regardless, I guess facing your opponents too early and helping your team is better than baiting them without a purpose. And that's not just a tip for gamble stacks, but for CS in general. It's very common for teammates to mess up a strategy or just play wrong, but if that's what they're doing, it's still better to help them than it is just to die every single round. Unless, of course, they're literally throwing on purpose, but that's another story. Anyway, now that we know how to properly play a gamble stack, that begs the question, what should you buy around it? And that's honestly a pretty difficult question to answer. Generally, a decent gamble stack works in the way that you can surprise your opponents, so you shouldn't have to hit the hardest of shots. Because of that, you don't need the fastest kill time on weapons, but you don't want to give your opponents too much time to 180 one-tap you either. So what usually works best is just some P250s with a CZ or 5.7 here and there. Of course, you could also buy Deagles, but that's usually not the best because it's a more expensive weapon and you also can't just run and gun with it. Running and gunning is really effective, especially if you're not trying to get hit because you don't have armor. So in these types of scenarios, having a gun that allows you to do just that is pretty darn beneficial. Although, I guess at the end of the day, it does of course remain a personal preference. That brings us to our daily tradition, our question of the day. Today's question is all about balancing, and should be pretty interesting. If you could make one change in CSGO, what would that be? Personally, I think I would rework the Desert Eagle. I think it's a great gun for the game and it's very skillful, but I don't like the two-shot body shot ability up close, and I also think that it should be less spammable. Then perhaps to make up for those nerfs, I give it increased accuracy to make it more reliable when firing slowly, and make it so that you can be sure to hit your shot, so the gun will be good. Anyway, it doesn't matter, what do you think though? What change would you make? Make sure to comment down below. Anyway, back to the video. With the gamble stack out of the way, what other ways remain? Well, of course, since the gamble stack is an option exclusive to the CT side, we also have to give the T side equivalent of it, and that's the 5-man rushing a site. Rushing a site with 5 people is similarly effective in the lower ranks because both rotations tend to be a bit slow and also because of the people that generally don't know how to counter the rushes. That being said, people also generally don't know how to rush optimally, especially in the case of half-buys. The truth is that rushing on a half-buy isn't very intuitive, but it isn't very difficult either. The key to success here is definitely have good flashes to give you space. You don't have to throw an entire execute, but you also do need 2 to 4 flashes that will fully blind anyone playing the most common angles. The goal here is to have these flashes pop as the first few people are going out, meaning that the players defending the bombsite will get blinded as the players come out rather than before it. It's very common for people just to toss flashes right before they actually peek out, and that happens because people are just scared to blind their teammates. That's very understandable in a round where both teams have equal buy, but in the case of a half buy where your opponents have rifles and your teammates only have pistols, getting your teammates blinded isn't the worst thing. After all, your goal is to get the pistols out and make it awkward for the opponents. It's much better for your flash to fully blind 3 teammates and 2 opponents on site, allowing your team to get out, than it is to fully blind the defenders seconds before your teammates peek. The reason that these pistol rounds are usually so hard to win is because it's difficult to win that opening, which results in not being a lot of space for people to maneuver. That may not seem like a big issue on the surface, but in the game, it usually results in a big spraydown of eco frags for a certain very happy eco cobra. Additionally, of being on top of the fact that there needs to be flashes though, once the flashes do come out, you also need to really rush out and flood the bomb site. It's very common for people to just try and take fights instead of jumping in and getting up close, but you really need to do that if you want to win with pistols. The expectation here is not to get the best chance at winning duels for the first people in, but rather just getting as much space as quickly as possible. This will allow people that are perhaps slightly later in to win the round. When it comes to buying for these plays, there's a few things that are very important. Firstly, don't buy a deagle, for the love of God. The deagle is perhaps the worst weapon to rush in with, and under no circumstances must be bought on a round like this. Secondly, prioritize a cheap pistol like the P250 or the Tech-9, and then afterwards, if you have the money, buy armor as well. The rush certainly isn't the most advanced of strategies, but it doesn't sacrifice in effectiveness, so make sure you use it whenever you think it might just work. Another way of going about it, and probably the most effective one at the higher ranks, is by playing a Puggy default with a stack potential. A default round is one, of course, when you just play the standard and split up forces. Basically, you'd buy a normal round, getting around the map and controlling working picks. In the higher ranks, people don't tend to rush as much, and people will try to get control first. Then, once they get that, they attempt to split a bomb site where they think they have the best odds of winning. That means that a stack will usually be found out before it can be effective, but it also means that you should be able to get 1v1 fights at quite a few spots around the map, both as a CT and as a team. And that's exactly what you should do. The chance of winning a round like that where your team only has pistols should be very low, but the chance of you winning a fight against a rifle with the deagle, well, it isn't too bad. Just hit a nice shot and you win 5-head. Of course, hitting a nice shot is difficult, but it's far from impossible, especially if your opponents are overconfident and may not be doing the smartest of things. After all, they're only playing against an eco round. If you're not really confident in your deagle though, and you might think that you might miss a shot, don't be afraid to visit ProGuides.com and have a talk with one of our coaches. There's probably a bigger issue at hand, so all you have to really do is identify it and then come up with a solution. I can guarantee you after just one session, you'll already be feeling much more confident and you'll be seeing yourself winning more half-buy rounds. The best way to go about winning these rounds is simply, you know, buying a deagle and taking risks across the map. For example, on Mirage, try to find a fight on ramp, peek the window as a T, or push mid as a CT. There's a bunch of aggressive plays that could give you a reasonably fair fight and therefore gives you a good chance of getting a 1D. Sure, you probably won't win every single duel, but if you win a duel on ramp, it suddenly allows you to get a lot of space and the round instantly becomes competitive. Same goes for mid. If you get a pick on, let's say example for a window or connector player, suddenly you have the real possibility of taking mid control and splitting into bomb sites. On the CT side, things are slightly different though. Obviously there, it's not about taking bomb sites and you won't really have to be aggressive to win a round there, the T's have to push into you. Nonetheless, you'll probably want to go aggressive somewhere because it's a risk very worth taking, and you'll agree when it goes right. If it goes wrong though, and you lose one player early, not all hope is lost. What you should do then is to go back and stack a bomb site. Sure, we already said that in the higher ranks, people are less likely to run back into a stack, but those chances go way up if you have some early action before and set up a late round stack. So if one or two fights turn bad and you lose a couple of players, the best and pretty much the only way that you're going to be coming out on top is risking it for the biscuit and sacking a bomb site, whichever one you feel like the opponents will come to. Alright, there's one more way. The final method that you can use to win a round is to set up an aggro play with the team somewhere. For example, as a CT team, you should push mid with a flash, peak ramp with a flash, hell, you could even set up B abs and pop flash there. There's a ton of different areas around the map where you can successfully do a flash play, and it gives you a really big chance of winning that round. In most cases, it'll grant you an early 5v4 or even 5v3, and two guns to win it. Afterwards, you guys can play and retake a 5v3 and clutch that round. The biggest benefit of this approach is that it's by far the cheapest. Oftentimes, you only need to spend $200 on a single player and the rest of the team can keep their USPS. You don't need to upgrade the pistols because honestly, it's really simple. Either you or your team picks one or two players that are full blind, or you guys probably lost the round. The only thing that you really need for these plays to be successful is one player with flash knowledge and the team willing to work together. That one is a little bit harder to find.
Well guys, that should give you a pretty good idea on how to win those ecos and half buys. So if you learned something, make sure you leave a like, subscribe, and ring that notification bell. While you're at it, head over to ProGuides.com to get access to courses written by players like Simple. Anyway, with all that being said, my name has been Nathan Ng. Shoot your shot, stay safe, stay healthy, and have a wonderful day. Peace.